You guys have any suggestions on good background music? Yo, what's up, Foolish Evan, Sly Cat, Bob Bonquist. How's it going? And the little TV. I have a question. I have a week off of practice, and the coach said no to moderate workouts. Good idea or no? Said no to moderate workouts. Week off from practice. Well, depends. If you have worked out too much, Kaya, then you should take a little break, but not a whole week off. You should do every day at least like stretches, yoga, just maintain that blood flow. Otherwise, like your muscles gonna, you know, stay dead in one state, and if you're not gonna move them, they're gonna interlock, so to say, and it's gonna be so much harder for you to get back. Just a couple of days, especially if you're an athlete, it's gonna get you sent back real bad. So, like light jog, stretching, yoga, and like quick little workouts, something like playful, you know, as I would do, like take a tennis ball and literally just throw it on like on the wall and try to hit it with your knuckles. It trains your reflexes and for eye coordination as well, and your speed. So that's really good for you. Oh, thank you so much, Chris Cross. Appreciate it. Yeah, I love the song too. So yeah, and another thing is I would highly suggest you to do a little bit of like fast weights, which is amazing for like to tonicize, like tone up your body, but like not even just to get fit, literally just do 3 reps at each weight only for like 5 times, and that's it. Like do like a bench press, quarter of a squat, and then a little bit of your glutes as well, and it's literally gonna like straighten up your body so quick, so fast, and just for that small amount of time. It's gonna take you for half an hour, I mean warm up and everything like that, yeah, but you should definitely stick to that. Just try it out, it's really really helpful. And another thing is, I'm not sure what your event is, if it's pole vault, watch pole vault videos and like at evening when you go to bed. So I'm not sure where you live, but for here it's 9:28 p.m. and I just usually watch in the evenings like a couple of videos and just mentally like rewatch them and relive them. Either my own or someone else's, it really depends on your own situation. But I watch multiple videos, not only myself, like there are a lot of good people who are very like athletic. They have very good techniques, so you gotta watch that too. Alright, so what we're gonna do today, we're gonna stretch out, you know, do little stretches. That's right, Drew John. Well, it's 9:29 right now. But yeah, let me know where you guys are from. Pole vault! Oh, that's awesome! Very cool, very cool. I love all the sports, but like pole vault. Pole vault's fam is the best. Yeah, you should not take off a whole week, especially if you're a pole vaulter, that's huge. Like every third day you should pole vault, honestly. Like it's, I know not everybody can do it, but if you can jump every third day, it's the ideally, because for any event, any sport, it's like 72 hours you have that muscle. You would say, they say it's a muscle memory, but really it's just like you, it doesn't, like your muscles and your mind is used to pole vaulting and used to that specific event that you did. So if you're waiting longer than that, your mind basically forgets a little bit about it. Even though like you've done it for years, it still forgets about it. So it's good to do these repetitions, like watching videos multiple times. And yeah, I just folded today, so my hand is a little dirty. I jump with the black stuff. There you go. This is black tape, and it's hard to get it off. But yeah, it doesn't really color. I mean, colors, but like it doesn't really color that much clothes. But yeah, today we're gonna roll out. I'm gonna show you guys how to really, really roll out your body after workout, after like hard workout, or just in general if you have like any issues. And anyone can do these. I just hope you guys have like balls laying around somewhere. And by balls, I mean like softball, baseball, golf ball, whatever. Tennis ball too. Tennis ball works too. So this one I really like because like it's hard and it gets to the right spots. Sure. Usually I warm up my body with this one, so I roll out every single part of my body, well, almost every single one, with this one, and then the foam roller, and get the blood flow basically going through my body, and then I work on trigger points, which is like. Some people call it knots, some people call it like muscle spasms, whatever. This one, whole thing, or tennis ball, or softball, or baseball, whatever, gets to those spots and really works on those specific parts of your body. But yeah, right now I'm gonna work on my forearm because I've been having a little issues with it, but nothing crazy. So what you wanna do? Just lay on the floor. Okay. So you lay down on the floor and you put the cross ball. So if you have forearm issues, what you want to do? Always look at the joint connections with the muscle tissue. So your forearm is most likely going to hurt somewhere around here and here. So you gotta work this one throughout. So you place it right here, a little below your elbow, and just put a pressure on it, like your other arm or like this. And for 15 seconds, just wait. Just hold on it. 12 to 15 seconds. And the 15 seconds are passed. Move it front and forward, like back and forward for about 12 strokes. You can tell like you got the right spot is when it really like hurts. I didn't get this one, Brendan. Okay, nice one though. So right here, try a bigger. And you can experiment with like different kind of equipments. So try a harder ball, try a softer one, and just to see for yourself which one is the best for you and what pain tolerance can you hold on. Hey yo, what's up? How's it going, guys? We're doing a trigger point therapy basically, and then finding ways how to hack your body's full potential abilities without hurting yourself. with the natural remedy, so to say. And then again, move forward, back and forward for like 15 strokes or 12 to 15 strokes. Awesome, thanks so much, appreciate it. Well, it's for your own health as well. We're doing qigong therapy, so if you guys have any issues like with your body, either YouTube, TikTok, Twitch, or by me, have any issues with your body, then let me know. I'll be able to help you too. Okay. Next one. Also, the tricep connection with your forearm could be an issue, like where your forearm is hurting, especially if you're talking about the wrist. You definitely want to like find that spot where exactly it's coming from. So it's the same thing. Hold here for 12-15 seconds. 5. And then back and forward strokes 4 times. Ooh. Yeah, hurts like a mother. Okay, what do you have there? Is that supposed to?
Yeah, this is helping me open up my forearm so my muscles with it. Let it go away from the pressure on my wrist, and that helps. Okay. Alright. Next thing, what we're gonna do is go over with the foam roller for the specific parts of the body. So we're gonna start with the calf. So what you wanna do is, you want to get the blood flow going there first. So just be patient and keep rolling, so to say.
Put this one a little higher. Go to your point through your work on hip flexors.
Oh yeah, hip flexors are a big thing.
Absolutely. And like if it's, there's, trigger point therapy is amazing. Like it works, it works miracles. Like the stuff that it actually like can give you, it's endless. It's such a valuable life hack that everybody should know. You work out every day, bro, right? Almost every day. But that's why trigger point therapy is so important for me and yoga. Because I need to recover every single day, so I have to know all this. So for me to be able, you know, to completely recover my body fully, because I'm using it all the time. For hip flexors, okay, here we go. I'll show you this. It's really good. So it's very important for you to foam roll like your quads first and your hamstrings, and then go to hip flexors. But I'm going to show you right straight from the hip flexors. So just first of all, foam rolling. This is one thing that you should do. After you're done foam rolling, again, 12 strokes on each muscle. That's like a must. After you've done your 12 strokes, this is what you do. Either you take a tennis ball, take a lacrosse ball, hell, you can even take a baseball or softball. But I would suggest you to start with the tennis ball just to test it out and see how it is. You place it on this one, on this muscle. I'll show you right here. This is the muscle that you have to put it on. I'll show you a picture. Hip flexors
are connected with the glutes. Then I'll show you the trigger points for hip flexors, because like you have to open up your glutes first and then you can only go to your hip flexors. Okay, here it is. Try to find a bigger picture. Okay, here we go. So, right here, one second, so right here, this is where you want to get it. You see where the bone is? Hopefully you can see it. So it's almost right next to the bone. It's on the side, almost on the edge. And that is the next trigger point. So right here, hopefully you guys can see it. So it's right next to the bone. And this is the area that is affected right now. And that's the next trigger point. So yeah. Alright.
So this is what you do. You put on it right there. Lay down, have your knee bent. And just feel that spot. It's gonna hurt. Like for me, like I can feel like it's a little tender. Wait for 15 seconds. And then do a little movement, like front to back. About 12 strokes. And then take it out. When you're done with this, there's another trigger point, which is closer like to the middle of your back. So you place there and you put it. And this one's on the back, so you lay it on. You also feel like a trigger point, a trigger spot that's gonna affect it, and then you feel like it's a little tender. And the same for 15 seconds, you're gonna stay there, and then move back a little bit. This should open up your glute a little bit. And don't overdo it. A lot of people who start doing this trigger therapy, they overdo it. Problems than you know issue. You have to be constant with it, you know. Open it up really well. And then after you're done with trigger therapy, I'll show you one more for the hip. So this is the next one. So it's right in front of you. This is gonna hurt. I'm already warning you. Hopefully you can see it. So it's right basically on that hip. Hopefully you can see, yeah, right on that hip. Not on the bone, just a little bit below the bone. And then you wait the same thing, 12-15 seconds as long as you can stand. And do little movements, 12-15 strokes. This should massage it and like open up a little bit. Remember, it's so much better to start with this one and then go with the, you know, specific equipment. It goes deeper in addition. Okay. Whew. That hurts. And then after you're done with this, what you want to do, you want to stretch it out. And the way you're going to stretch it out is place this leg on the wall. Hold up. These guys can see it. Okay. Place this leg on the wall. And you just stretch this hip forward. And you'll feel how it's going to stretch it out really well. the stretch is about also like 12 to 15 seconds.
Not really bad. Proceed to the next hip.
Yeah.
So that's how you release your hips.
Well, at least one part of it. I showed only like three trigger points, but like honestly, there's so many more. But the basics are good too. You'll if you learn those, they'll definitely open up your hip flexors for sure. But remember, to foam roll first, like it's very, very important. Those 12 strokes at first, just with a foam roller. Then, when the muscle is like warmed up, then start using these miracle balls. And then do it for about 3 times a day. And it doesn't take long if it just hip flexor. And it really depends how long you have had it. And if you haven't had it for a longer time, you're gonna have to work a little bit harder. So when you're gonna see the effect and result, you definitely will want to work on it really focused. Because like, later on, like it could be even worse. Like it could grow worse. Maybe the pain goes away, but if you're gonna, you know, just ignore it, it's still creating deformation in your body, which you wanna avoid as much as possible, especially if you're young. Start act upon it as soon as possible, because later on when you're gonna get older, like it's gonna be so much harder to get rid of it, and it's gonna create a whole lot of issues. So that's how it is. For now, my right calf is pretty uptight, and I gotta roll it out and show you guys how to get. I'll open up your calves. Yeah. Don't overdo it in one time though. Better have multiple times for smaller sessions than one big time. And it's not gonna take you that long either. But remember, like when you do the trigger point therapy, this combination, what I just showed you, is tops, the best you can ever have. Like, I wish someone had told me this, like, I don't know, when I started foam rolling, but no one did. So foam roll first, warm up the muscle, trigger point therapy afterwards, then do the strokes, and then stretch. So these three parts, if you do these, you'll be able to take care of yourself. You won't have to spend, I don't know, hundreds and thousands of dollars of like on surgery or a masseuse. Although a masseuse and a therapist is a very good option too if you don't, you know, have the time or the energy to invest in yourself or take care of yourself. There are other people who learn a little bit. That's why we pay money for them. So yeah. Doing 12 strokes at each side. Starting here, we're gonna go lower, then on the other side, and then inner calf. That's what we do.
here. Up. Especially if you're a driver, like if you drive a car, like these things, flex the ass so quick, it's not even funny. Okay, now for trigger point therapy, where are we going to place this one? I'm going to place it right on top here, right below the little bone, that's right there, you just go a little bit lower, okay? And it's good to have like a clothing. Clothing on top of it if you want to do your foot there, because you don't want your skin, you know, to break, to get dry. It's good to have the clothing behind. And then again, those 12 to 15 strokes are very crucial to. You want to have those because that's going to move the blood, move the toxins out of that muscle and activate its recovery much more quicker, much faster. Excess chemicals out of it. Now, next point we're gonna go. So we started here, we're going a little lower here, so about like four or three fingers lower. We can gradually go lower and lower. Again, we're gonna wait for like 12 to 15 seconds, and then go lower. Forget to share, guys. Help your friends and family out too. This is a life lesson that everyone can learn, and it's so important to learn it better sooner than later. So.
Thank you guys for sharing. Okay, next part. It's gonna be, so it was here. We're gonna go on the, gonna little lower. It's gonna be on the middle of the calf, basically. Oof. And you'll feel it when it's like very tender, painful. That's the spot. Again, you don't want to overdo it. Just do it a little bit, you know, each time. Have your like, small little sessions and long. It's just going to take longer for your body to recover after that long session. And it's quite possible you'll break the muscle too much and it's going to be harder for it to recover. 12 strokes. Or 15, 12 to 15. When you feel like you need a little more, just go for it. Have fun with it. Next one is going to be a little more. It's going to be right here. So we're just working on one side for now. And then we're going to go a little more and more. Another trick is if you're not. That's the third part about to stretch the muscle, and it's like very effective. So you put a pressure on part of the muscle that is the tightest, and then you do a contraction of that muscle body part. And this is going to stretch out the muscle and lengthen it. And actually, it's going to make longer the muscle. And the longer the muscle is, the stronger it's going to be. Obviously, if it's too long, it's going to lose its property, but just long enough, and it's going to be very, very strong. Okay. 15 strokes. Oh yeah, another good tip is if you like hit it, if you hit your muscle, it also activates and it recovers much more quicker, much more faster. So right now we can put it on the middle, right on the middle where the calf's muscle is combining together. Put your leg around on top of it. Find the right spot, you'll feel it. You'll feel that it's gonna hurt. And put the pressure on top of it. And then if you want, you can move your foot back and forward, which is gonna lengthen the muscle. It's gonna hurt a little more, but it's very, very effective. Do a contraction of your foot. Next one, we can go to the inner calf, which is going to be right here. So you place it here to the lowest part of the gap on your left side in here. Good guys. Peace out. If you guys have any other questions, by the way, just direct me. whichever platform you're on, and if you can. If not, then message me on Instagram. I'll try to answer, anyone that I'm possibly able to.